Jerry, come on. We gotta go. You gotta come with me, Jerry.
Rick?
It's important, Jerry. The fate of the galaxy rests on your shoulders. Let's go. Put some pants on. Never mind. There's no time for pants, Jerry. I'll make you a pair of pants on the way. It's a Rick and Jerry adventure. Rick and Jerry episode. Thought, hey, what about Jerry? He's good with regular folk. This is a real situation where Jerry could really shine. He's a master convincer.
Rick, I'm not an idiot. I know what this is.
Oh, okay. Well, I told Morty, look, parents get divorced. They get sad. He'll be fine. But I think he's worried you're gonna, you know. And you know how Morty gets when he gets emotional. It impedes my work. So I told him I'd take you out and give you a win.
Wait, my son asked you to take me on some kind of pity adventure to keep me from killing myself?
Wait, what did you think it was?
An execution.
Jeez, you really do need a win.
No, I don't know. I mean, you never made me the pants, so...
So you thought I was gonna drive you into the middle of the galaxy and shove you into the vacuum of space with your dick hanging out? And we're seeing how you'd act if that were about to happen? I mean, I'll make you the pants right now. Take me 2 seconds to make you
pants. I have pants at home.
Jerry, if I make pants, they'll be better than your pants at home. Also, if I wanted to kill you...
Yeah, I get it. It'd be amazing. Please, take me home. I'll tell my son we had an amazing adventure.
Well, if it's all the same, could we go get our story straight? Because you're a terrible liar.
You called me a master convincer!
You believed me?
Hello. So today I'm going to debut Rick and Morty, the Whirly, Whirly Conspiracy. That's Rick and Morty Season 3, Episode 5, yeah. And, well, the first reference is going to be to Alice in the Wonder World. So the entire scene where Summer enlarged to the Morphine XE to the point where she destroys the garage is a reference to Alice in Wonderland. This episode is actually good. I'll enjoy it a lot. Now, this is actually Rick and Morty. I was hoping for. This was clever jokes. I'm going to be pausing this and making a reference at the same time. The view and references. So this reference is to Attack of the 50-Foot Woman, Summer Attack and Journey towards Ethan and Trisha is reference to Attack of the 50-Foot Woman. So this episode has clever jokes, nice reference to the previous episodes, mind-blowing moment, excellent pacing and character developments. Both storylines were kept interesting, as well depth from movies like Fifth Element or Honey, I Blew Up the Kid. Let me stop there and go to the reference. This is a reference to, if you see in the M, it's a reference to Speed Racer, the 1967 TV series. The Match 5 logo can be seen on the Whirly Dirly ride. So, I waited this part as a dream after the Rick Chang redemption, and it lived for my expectations. While Vindicator 3 was quite lacking in some of Rick and Morty classic style, they bring it back with this fantastic episode filled with everything I love about the show. Even that this is not, well, it's actually a great episode for me, and I enjoyed it quite a lot. And this is a reference to The Big Chill, when Rick Sanchez says, well, yo, what's up, Big Chill? So this was lacking. It was a great humor, weird worlds with the references to 2001 Space Odyssey. And even that someone who thought in doing an episode about Jerry, you think it's not going to be good because everyone hates Jerry. And, well, that's what Rick makes you think. And that's what makes you think this episode isn't going to be well. Well, there we see a device from Back to the Future, similar to the flux capacitor is seen in Rick's lab. This is the green thing right there that you see in the machine. In this season, I think there are two kinds of twists. One is the characters facing a choice, either A or B. The other is there are option A and option B. The character chooses what the hell. There was a like a way that... Oh, yeah. Sorry, another reference. I didn't miss anything, right? Shit! No, sorry. So, Rick Sanchez says, "Yo, what's up, big chill? Don't go into the teleport." That's a reference to The Fly, a movie of 1986. So, this episode is quite good. Shit. This is one is good. Do you see how Rick and Jerry get involved, being friends in a weird way? I'm going to tell you the ranked on which episode is what best episode is. So, okay, this is a reference to Hellraiser because Clive Barker was one of the creators of Hellraiser. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is my number 6 best episodes of this season. And we see a twist seeing why, like, some Beth is not being quite a good mother, and we see her doing therapy with Claws of the horses and all of the stuff, and we see that they're having consequences, big consequences by the divorce. So this is a reference to Dead Again. Because, well, in the movie, the reference to there will be two funerals, and they die again, and die again, then it's quoted in the dialogue. So, finally, after my loyalty was put to the test the past few weeks, Rick and Morty is actually fucking back. Right, finally an episode that made you wonder about the entire season this far. What took them so long? But let's quiet wailing about the past. This episode brought back everything that makes Rick and Morty so great. This is a reference to Honey, I Blew Up of the Kids. Summer uses a growth ray to make herself bigger, similar to the size ray from this movie. So, also there's an interesting development here for both Jerry and Morty. Jerry seems to make his first careful moves into becoming less obsessed with being a single father, and also Morty seems to have grown more confident. He even has a few kick-ass dialogue moments confronting both his mother and Ethan. This episode underlines the great character potential to Morty has outside of the familiar Rick and Morty dynamic. So this is a reference to the movie I Have No Mouth and I Must Scream, a 1995 video game, Eden's Punishment of a God Bloody Horror imposed by Morty. This is the same thing that they do in the video game. So, after Pickle Rick, I had become rather cautious of the need for character development in Rick and Morty. But this episode, perhaps the best since the Rick Change Redemption, shows that if self-development is properly blended into the familiar formula, this series has potential for at least one more season, hopefully more. What we're seeing right now is a reference to a death scene in Resident Evil, the movie, when he is struggling, arresting him into killing him, but later he's saved by Jerry. So, for me personally, I didn't find this to be one of the best episodes, but still great to watch. So this other reference is obviously just to Avatar, because Rick Sanchez says, "I want cookies and a 90 minute cut of Avatar." So yeah, this is a still great episode to watch. This episode features Jerry deciding to go on an adventure with Rick. They travel to a theme park, but someone has been working with Jerry to kill Rick, yet another one of his old enemies. I kind of like how casual they're about going on their adventures. They really do each want to work with each other, albeit redundantly. There's a sand subplot where Summer wishes she was more beautiful, and while using a growth ray to get larger breasts, turned into a giant. a giant. This is a reference, obviously, to Attack on Titan. We see the muscles. Also, the giant's armor design is based on Colossal Titan from Attack on Titan. It's a great anime, you should watch it. Maybe one of the best animes there is right now. Well, I didn't like the second season. I was, when it's going to start the plot, the good story, but it never happened. Well, yeah. I like how Morty is mad that this stuff is happening even without Rick, because we think that Rick sent Jerry with Jerry for trying to Jerry to not to kill himself, but it's actually Morty want to get rid of Rick. That's something that Rick doesn't get, and it's like saying that Morty is kind of smart. So this is a reference to Toy Story 3, the part where we see Buzz being trapped to the chair and being claimed to Lotso. So there's a big reference there, the chair and all of that. This is my last reference, I think. No, I have one more. Well, let's keep with the review. So the best part, this is the other reference, that is the 2001 Space Odyssey. The best part is probably when Rick, Jerry, and this one Alan about to kill Rick end up getting trapped in a wormhole like it's happening in this image. And we get this insane animation sequence. Nowadays we're used to acid trip dimensions. This one is still wonderfully creative as we see everything go insane and even have the characters. There's a little image that I didn't put in the video, but if you see the episode, you see Rick carrying the alien like a woman, but in the chimney he has two statues, Bet and Bird Person. So there's like the most important things for him, his family and his friends. So this was a great episode. I loved it. Honey, I blew up the baby. So subscribe to later in the night I'm going to do a review and reaction. I'm going to do an actual reaction of Star Wars Episode 8, the trailer. Yeah, subscribe, like the video, and we'll see you later.